The latest version of iOS is still fresh, so let's see how Apple's operating system has evolved from 2007 to the present. The first iPhone, released in 2007, came with iPhone OS 1, the first version of Apple's operating system. As you can see, the operating system was not called iOS at the time of launch, but iPhone OS, only since version 4 being called iOS. iPhone OS didn't have an App Store or iTunes Store, but it came with Mail, Calendar, Photos, Clock, Text, Safari, Notes, YouTube, Computer, Maps, Settings, Camera, Stocks, and Phone. With the launch of iPhone 3G in 2008 came iOS 2. It was equipped with the most anticipated application, the App Store, where over 500 applications were available at launch. At the same time, GPS navigation, scientific computer, and contacts was introduced, which came with a contact search function. The next version of iOS was released in 2009. iOS 3 came with the cut, copy, paste function, the Spotlight search function, which allowed searching at the system level, such as contacts, emails, or other applications. At the same time, support was introduced for MMS, video recording support on iPhone 3GS, and with the new Voice Memos application, users could record their voice.
Hey, Johnny.
In 2010, Apple released iOS 4, the iPhone 4 operating system. This version came with features for multitasking, application folders, spell checking, and customized Spotlight searching, iBooks, FaceTime, Game Center, Personal Hotspot, AirPrint, and AirPlay have also been introduced. iOS 5 came on the iPhone 4S in 2011. One of the most important features introduced on this version was Siri, the virtual assistant that replaced voice control. Changes have also been made to the notification system, which now displayed temporary banners at the top of the screen. iCloud, Newsstand, iTunes, which syncs iTunes over Wi-Fi, and iMessage have also been introduced. iOS 6 was launched in 2012 and came with a new application, Apple Maps, which replaced the old Google Maps. iOS 6 also came with a podcast application and an application called Passbook, which manages various tickets. Changes have also been made to the camera, which can now take photos in panorama mode, and there's a new application, Photo Sharing.
Choose the photos you'd like to share. Choose the friends with whom you'd like to share them. And that's it, you're done.
iOS 7 came on the iPhone 5S and 5C in 2013 and came with a new design. Flat icons, a new slide to unlock function, and new animations. One of the most important features introduced was Touch ID, which allows users to unlock their devices using their fingerprint. Changes have also been made to the Notification Center, providing quick access to features such as Wi-Fi, Do Not Disturb, Bluetooth, brightness, and volume. AirDrop was the new feature that allowed users to share media files with other people around them.
Today, we're announcing iOS 8.
The next operating system was iOS 8, launched in 2014. The most important application introduced was Apple Pay, a mobile payment service and digital wallet. Another interesting feature was Continuity, an application that facilitates the transfer of data between mobile devices and computers. Apple also launched HomeKit for the first time, an application with which users could control the entire house using the iPhone as a remote control.
Now looking forward to iOS 9, and as we conceived of what we wanted to accomplish, first and foremost, we wanted to elevate the foundations of the platform. Things like extending your battery life, improving performance, and enhancing the security to protect customer data.
iOS 9 was Apple's next operating system and came with improvements in terms of stability, speed, and performance. 3D Touch and the low power mode function have been introduced. Last but not least, Night Shift was introduced, which changes the color of the device's display in warmer shades, and the Passbook application became Wallet and offered support for various cards.
I'm pleased to introduce iOS 10.
iOS 10 was released in 2016 and came with lock screen enhancements. Messages has additional emojis, Maps has been revised, Photos has an algorithmic search called Memories, and Siri is compatible with third-party applications. Also, users could finally delete pre-installed applications.
We're going to take the world's best and most advanced mobile operating system and turn it up to 11.
iOS 11 was released in 2017 and comes with design changes. The Siri application is smarter, can find and synchronize information on multiple devices, can anticipate what the user wants, and can translate English into multiple languages. Messages could send money to friends via iMessage using Apple Pay. iOS 12 came with an interesting feature, Screen Time, which displays the number of hours the user spends on the iPhone, and the user can set application usage limits. Notifications are now grouped and can be managed much better. Thus, if the user receives 100 emails, they will be grouped, not displayed separately. Messages came with Memoji, customizable 3D animations, Siri now had shortcuts, and Photos allowed separate folders with content, more efficient search, and video slideshows with photos.
iOS 13 is a huge release packed with lots of capabilities, but we know that nothing is more important to our iPhone users than performance.
iOS 13 was released in 2019 and comes with improvements to the time to update and launch applications, and Face ID is 30% faster. Apple has introduced dark mode, which can be programmed to activate according to preferences. The Photos application can now show a certain selection in the user's life by days, months, or years. iOS 14 came with major improvements. Widgets have been completely redesigned, providing more information and can be added to the main screen. The new application library automatically organizes applications to make them easier to navigate and view, and calls have a much more compact display. New styles and Memoji stickers have been introduced, which have criteria, age, face masks, hair types, and accessories. Changes have also been made to the Translate application, so if the phone is in landscape mode and the user touches the single microphone button to say something, Translate will immediately translate it into the chosen language. iOS 15, Apple's latest operating system, offers more security and privacy. To make it easier to work remotely, Apple has improved the messaging app, FaceTime, which supports web or Android conferencing, and the SharePlay feature, which allows FaceTime video callers to watch videos or listen to audio together and share screens. Apple has introduced Focus, an app that can temporarily stop all notifications and let other people and apps know you're busy. Live Text detects text in photos and converts it to text, and you can keep your ID cards in your wallet. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video. See you in the next video.